let me change gears. After that little encounter with some statistics, I need to get my audience back. Now, I'm also interested in cultural change that was brought about, say, by improved mail service, the circulation of newspapers, the circulation of catalogs showing agricultural implements, the increased circulation of goods in the countryside that first begin to show up, including tins of tea and that kind of thing. So here we have an adverb, as the English would say, but this is a French one. And this arresting poster tells us that we can get pure pasteurized milk from the Vosgien, as promised by the Guillot brothers, whose enterprise is in Montigny-sur-Vosgien in the department called Côte d'Or. Now, so try to imagine then what change this might have to a consumer's mental geography. A person who goes into their local store in Paris, let's say, and sees this poster, or perhaps passes it on a building wall covering over, of course this is in France, the statement that says posting bills is strictly illegal, and of course this would be over it. And the thought comes to a person's mind that, well, dis donc, où se trouve le vin Jean? Où se trouve le Montigny sur Vosgien? C'est où? Où se trouve ça? So anyhow, so where in the world is the Vosgien? Where is Montigny sur Vosgien? And those kinds of questions. So it's I hypothesize that small little places like Vosgien, the Montigny is a little town in the rural Burgundy with about 700 souls in the time of 1894 when this poster was published. So it's advertisements like this that begin to acquaint urban folk with the sources of the milk and other products that they're beginning to, they begin to consume more and more, because the railway has allowed like fresh milk to be brought in from very far distances. In England, farmers' wives might be sitting and having some tea as they talk about the tin that has these very interesting figures on it. Tea from Ceylon, a conversation piece, turns out to be a sort of lesson in geography. Or at least it's a lesson to stimulate the geography of imagination, imagine geography. Meanwhile, the husbands are in the barn or the parlor are talking about the latest catalog of farm implements that somebody points out, well, these are made in Oxfordshire, in Banbury. Where's that? Or the annual calendar from Bibby's, who is a manufacturer of cow food, Bibby's dairy cakes, unequaled milk production once you feed your cows this. And so with the calendar that comes free, people get, rural farmers and so forth can get a sense of, well, this is their plant in Liverpool.